Hey, what's up, everyone, and once again, welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Mipha's Grace is ready. Good to know. Last time, we finished up our side quest list, except for, of course, Trial of the Sword. We did a couple that required us to go up into Hyrule Castle, and now we have this incredible Royal Guard's gear, uniform, all that, so we're feeling pretty snazzy right now. And in this episode, we're going to be taking on the things that I currently have pinned, because there's a few. We got this green pin over here, a red one down here, and also a blue one right down here. So how about we head up to this shrine on the Birida Lookout, and paraglide on down. Bye, horse! I wanted to go ahead and get these knocked out in this episode so that our map's a little bit more cleaned up, because I've pinned a lot of things over the episodes and then just not gone to do them. So it felt like as good of a time as any, now that we've got all of our quests and everything completed, to do this. So the fact that our shrine sensor is going off tells me that what I pinned was just a shrine. That looks like a shrine to me. Just hidden behind this rock right here. Oh yeah, absolutely. And there goes our radar. Okay, I forgot that was gonna happen. But that's fine. The Dakota Shrine. Let's do this. It is a bit of a bummer that we don't have our radar here. This sucks. I hate this, because we can't even teleport out, which is the worst part. But, anyway. Into the shrine. The weird thing is, once we've completed this shrine, we'll be able to teleport to it, we just can't teleport from it, which is strange. Electric path. Okay. I imagine that this isn't gonna be too bad. Oh, hello. Oh, we don't need to waste an ancient arrow on this little dude, Link. I think a regular one will do. He's not exactly very strengthy, he just had one ancient spring. Okay, so that is not something we want to shoot with an arrow. That's not what it's for. Okay. Let's see here. Electric ball thing over there. That's gonna take us back up there. Okay, this stuff up top too. So I'm guessing we just gotta drag that. Or grab it and bring it over and... Or is that controlling this lift right here? I guess there's one way to find out. Because I don't see another way we can go once we're over here. So I believe that this is just showing you that, hey, this is what's powering it. So bring that with you, right? No. This lift is no longer moving. Okay. Well, that's good to know. Is it also controlling this here and I just didn't notice? Hold on, I gotta remember to go back because there was definitely stuff back at the start. Okay, so that... Huh. Is there something over there that I just didn't see? It's like, I can't bring this over there. And nor can I get up there. So what have I missed here? If I pick that up, it's not going to come back with me. So I gotta just look without it, I suppose. Can't move that. Let's just check up here. Let's take a quick look. Okay, so this is just another elevator. Am I missing something here? Because there's only one object around here that I can even move. Unless I've missed something back here. Which I have not. Okay, well, let's figure this out. Oh, I figured it out. I can just do this. It still counts. You just have to put the thing on the metal bar as you're going over. Oh, that's cool. That's really cool, actually. Because it still electrifies it, so of course it does. Alright, cool. So then, put you here. Yeah, okay, that takes it up. Which leads to right here. I'm gonna bring this with me again. Do I need it with me? I got like a bunch of- oh. Just a couple of little dudes down there, okay. I'm just gonna take that guy down, he's gonna get real confused. And then take that guy down. Not bad. Not bad, Link. Alright, let's bring this with us. We're probably gonna need it. It's called Electric Path, so that would make sense. Chest right here. There's also a chest there. Which, now that I think about it... Wait, how... That's the... Do I have to move this, maybe? Can I even move this? Do any of you move? No? Ancient screw. Do you move down? No, I can't move any of that. I can move this. Weird. Yeah, the chest that's on the other side of that is, like, above where I picked this thing up from. Which tells me that we need that over- Oh, God! Which tells me that we need that over there? But I couldn't figure out how to make it work. Oh, I can just push that. I didn't realize I could just push it. Let me just take a look around. Okay, so there's a thing down there. Which is a thing that we hit. What do you do? Okay, you bring that up. Oh, wait. No. I was forgetting where- I was misjudging where I was. This is something different. The chest is, like, way back at the start, or... I think. I'm confused. I'm confused about where everything is. Yeah, so we definitely don't have all the chests in here. Please come back down. I can't get out of here without you. Okay, good. It is coming back. I thought maybe we were... You know, just a tad screwed there for a second. Also, I realized the reason why we took those guys down in one hit is probably because we have the Royal Guard's bow on. This thing is very strong. So that makes sense. Alright, so hop off of here. I think we've gotten everything we can get over this way. I don't see... I see a chain. Oh, hang on, where's that chain going? All the way up there. Oh, I hadn't even seen all of that stuff up there. Okay, so we still got a ways to go. We still got a few things to figure out here. Where's the... It's here. I need this. I need you, my friend. So, I can't just, like, put that up there. Let's figure out this chest. Let's figure out this chest down here first. That's a very easy chest, isn't it? Okay, I was making this seem a lot more complicated than it is. You just do that to get the chest. Alright. Moonlight Scimitar. I don't need it, but I need this chest to count as completed, so... I'll just drop what I'm currently holding, pick it up. Get that in my inventory. It's got long throw. Let's test that out. Ah! That went kind of far, I guess. Get back on here. Pick you up. And move on. Okay. Is that all the chests? That's not all the chests still. Okay. Where does this chain go? Over there, and I think that's where it ends. Okay. Cool. I still haven't quite figured out how to do anything with these. Like, they just don't move. Oh, hang on, that one moved a little bit. It's moving ever so slightly. I just don't know what else we can do with them. We can just electrify the floor. I don't know what it's there for. What if I did a shock arrow? Would that count? I did. It moved it. It's only going to be temporary, but... That shows us what it does. Is that permanently electrified, actually? Wait. Is it? It is. It's actually permanently electrified. Oh. I feel like that shouldn't have worked like that. I gotta figure out how to get up there. There is clearly a way for us to get up high. Wait, it's the thing I just activated, isn't it? It's this. So, I'm just a little confused if they intended for you to use a shock arrow there, or if I can just... I can just do that. I can just reach up there. Alright, wow, I am overthinking these shrines. But it's fine, because we figured it out. We got it going. We're not gonna make it. No, we made it. Okay, good. Send me up, please. Are you... Okay, good. I thought it wasn't gonna go back up. Cool. So then we can put this down here to permanently... Oh. What did that do? I guess that just permanently electrified the whole thing and it's bringing this thing over for us to stand on, is it? Where are you gonna go to? Right here? Okay! thank you, lift. And then I guess I'm gonna have to move this. So I guess the shock arrow was just a temporary electrification. That's all I can really think of there. Okay, you need to get out of the way. Okay, is that good? Is that good enough? I think there's a chest hidden behind this thing. There is. So, I'm gonna have to do a real funky shield jump to get back over, or just wait for this platform. I don't want to have to do either. Unless there's something beneath. I don't think so. Ooh, radiant shield with shield guard up plus 13. That's a decent one. That's a really decent shield. Let's go ahead and drop... Oh, we have a rusty shield. Yeah, goodbye. I think it has, like, a little bit of a modifier on it, but... I think I'll keep the radiant shield. Alright, can we do this? With a fancy little shield jump? Maybe. Oh yeah, that wasn't anywhere near as far as I thought. And that's all the chests, alright. Wow, that was actually a pretty complex shrine, but I mean, it's down in the Gerudo Desert where we can't even see it, so... That kind of makes sense, I suppose. Give me my spirit orb, we now have 8, that's 2 level ups waiting for us. Next up on the agenda, assuming we can find it... Oh, the storm stopped. Oh, I guess it's just a temporary storm. Okay. There's also a campfire right there, I just noticed. Oh, sand seal, wait. Super helpful, let me go ahead and ice arrow you real quick. Did that not... work? Hit him with an ice... Why is that not working? We're supposed to be able to freeze him. Alright, I guess we're not taking a sand seal. Hello, Lizalfos. Shh, please hit him. Okay, does that just not work? No, it's not that. It's the bombs, isn't it? We're supposed to use the bombs. Oh my god. I'm thinking of horses. There, stun him with the bomb. And then grab a hold. My god. Let me switch shields to one that's not my most powerful shield. Yeah, yeah. Ah, woo. Get out of here. I'm leaving anyway. Because I have another marker to go to. There's a Lizalfos right there. Goodbye. I was going to try and dash right into him, but it didn't work. Oh, this way, sand seal, this way. To the red marker. Go all around this. Are we being followed? No, I thought we had someone right behind us. Hey! Wow, this is further than I thought. I'm very glad that I chose to use a sand seal. Because I almost didn't. I almost did not. Alright, let's see. Looks like this might be something as well. Oh, is this... Oh, no, this is just where we're going. This is what I pinned. Alright, thank you, Sand Seal. That's all I needed, buddy. Here we are. The 7 heroines. We've already found the 8th heroine statue. This is the rest of them. As you can see, there's a way to climb up, but we're not going to do that. We're just going to float into the middle. The East Gerudo Ruins. There's a lot going on in here. As you can see, balls. There are balls. And each of these balls has a little symbol on it. Each of those little symbols corresponds with... something. Is it these things? Yeah, okay. Some of them are just a little bit harder to see, and I think some of them aren't, like, in... Okay, one of them's right there. That's the pause symbol. This one, I think, is on its foot? No? I guess maybe it's gonna be like a... process of elimination type thing. This one's like the red... Okay, there's one up on its head up there. That's the two dots. This one... I don't see it on that. Don't pin it, Link. We're already here. You don't have to pin the thing that you're standing right next to. Yeah, so some of these are a little harder to see. I think that's why they have the thing at the back. For you to be able to climb up and figure them out. Is this one? No, oh my god. And also, you may have noticed, not all of the balls are here. Some of them are missing or hiding somewhere. So we're gonna have to find them all. That's gonna be fun. I guess let's just get started. We'll run over here. Grab the one that we can see. Come here. Come here. Alright, what is this one? This is the green little symbol. I think we've seen this one on... You were the pause symbol. Okay, is it that? That looks sort of right. I'm gonna guess that this is correct. It looks right. Link does not want to get off of the tiny little ledge. Alright. You go in there. That seems right. I mean, it's not green, but it's the same symbol, so we'll leave it there for now. You are the red symbol. I'm gonna put them all in the middle so that we can see them. And I think that the other ones are gonna be kind of hidden elsewhere. That's the two dots. We've definitely seen the two dots. You are the two dots. Okay. So that's another one figured out. You get in there. And then this one was the sort of blue teardrop looking thing. Alright, so we got the red one and the blue one. And it looks like there's another one all the way over there. And then the other ones, I don't know where the other ones are hiding. They've got to be in this area. And I imagine there's some behind the statues on the other side, maybe. Alright, pull that one out. Come on. Okay, this is the V symbol sort of thing. Let me check the symbol on this one. Oh, is that the green? Wait. I can't actually tell what this one is from a distance. That's a teardrop. It's a green teardrop, like a quotation mark almost. But I guess the colors probably don't matter. At least I'm assuming that the colors don't matter, because I think they're all just going to be different symbols. So it's actually going to be the red one right here, maybe. I don't know, I'll put it here for now. Just let it sit there. Okay, you, we need to figure out what your symbol is. Because I don't see it. And you as well, we don't have your symbol. Your sword's broken, I've noticed. Okay, it's up. No, it's not up there. Your sword is extremely broken. What happened? Oh. Okay, so that one's a yellow circle. We don't have that yet. We have not found the circle one yet. You are the two dots that we already did. Alright, let's figure out yours. You right here. You have a lot of, like, climbing pieces on the back of you. Which tells me I've got to go all the way up there. But also I have Revali's Gale, so I may not actually need to do that. But we'll do it the old-fashioned way. We'll do what the game wants us to do here. Or we will fall down. Alright, Revali, help me out, bud. Just take me all the way up here. Around the side. Oh, grab the wall, Link. And we're going up to the top. Oh, it's right there, is it? Okay, this one's like the weird triangle thing. But why can we get up here? Oh. Maybe take the ladder, Link. There's no reason not to take the ladder. It's right there. Okay, so what is this one hiding? Nothing? I can just go up here? Does this do something? Let me do a regular arrow. No, you don't do anything. Okay. Oh, well, there's one of the balls. At least from up here, we can see them all. We got some already in. Is that the last ball, actually? I think it might be. It is. That is the last one. So let's go grab it. Gotta remember that was the triangle one that we just did. Oh, this is the circle. Which I think is this one, isn't it? The one that we're standing on? If it's not, it's the one right next to it. It was on the sword. Yes, this is this one. So you come here. And you get... Wait, where am I going? Where am I taking this thing? It needs to go over here. You go in here, and then by process of elimination, we know that that one was the funky triangle thing, which is you. You're going into here. And then we only have one left, so this has to be whichever one over here doesn't have a ball in it right now. Which was this one? Is that it? Is that everything? Aha! Yeah, that was it. The Korsh Ohu Shrine. I want to say this is another one that technically has a shrine quest that we just haven't talked to the right person. I could be wrong, but either way, that one's opened up, so let's get in. It's probably a blessing. Let's see if we see water. Yeah, it's a blessing. Well, I'm actually happy with that because I wanted to knock out one more shrine in this episode. And I think the last one is not going to be a blessing. Flame Spear with critical hit. A magical spear forged in the magma of Death Mountain. Attack when the blade glows to expel powerful flames. It's not super strong. But again, we need this shrine to count as completed, so we'll go ahead and grab it. And then get rid of it. I don't want to use this Forest Dweller sword that we have. I'm just holding on to it because, again, it's a rare weapon. I just wish we could, like, put it up in Link's house, but we can't. I think we need to do some Korok hunting soon, because then we can go to Hestu and get all the rest of our upgrades and just be able to hold on to, like, everything that we pick up. There's our Spirit Orb. Thank you, sir. So the next and possibly last thing we're going to be doing in this episode is, of course, the green pin over here, which is right up on top of this mountain. We pinned it from down at the stable, I believe. So I think our best bet for getting there is going to be this tower. I think there is also a shrine down here by the stable that I couldn't find. So if we have time, I'll look for that. But if not, we're just heading up a mountain today. Once we're done with this one, by the way, this will be 90 shrines. We've done 89 so far, so there's only 30 left outside of DLC-related stuff, so we're closing in on the end, folks. It's kind of surprising, but we are. Also, I need to take off anything metal, because goddamn, I don't want to use my Forest Dweller's bow. Put on a duplex bow, just don't use it all, Link. And also, this, god, do we have anything? Guardian stuff is fine. We'll use a guardian sword. Okay, they're gonna get struck by lightning just for holding their weapons, so keep away! Oh god. Oh god! Link, grab the wall. Oh no. We've fallen a little bit too far down here. This is potentially a problem. Let me put on my climbing gear. I didn't mean to jump off the cliff like that. All the climbing gear, so we can hopefully get up. Jump! Okay, let him go for a little bit. No, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, it's like 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Jump! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. Oh my god, he just barely made it. How are these guys not dead? They should definitely be dead right now. Because they're holding metal weapons and lightning is striking near them. Anyway, why am I here? Because this is where we get these. I wanted to, excuse me. I wanted to pick up some more hardy durians while we were here. I knew we'd be passing through this area, so it kind of made sense for us to do that in my mind. Of course, stasis is going to help us find them. We know that hardy durians are pretty incredible. What the heck? There's a whole stack of them just sitting over here. We'll just scoop those up real quick. I guess also Mighty Thistle. There's some dead dudes trying to kill us right now. Don't worry about it. Am I using my guardian sword to cut down trees? Yes. Should I be doing that? No, but I am limited on options right now because of the lightning, so I kind of have to. Also, I realize I'm using the Forest Dweller shield. I don't want to be using that because that's another one of those rare weapons or rare pieces of gear. All right, give me that durian. You're not going to hit me. I am too fast. It's as simple as that, my guy. Yeah, I'm just too fast for you. You're a dead bokoblin. I don't think okay. That's what I get for talking smack. Die, please. How'd that not kill you? I hit him square in the face and nothing happened. Alright, note to self, don't- there's a dead fish in this hole. What? Okay. Note to self, don't smack talk the dead bokoblins. They will kill you. Or they will try. Okay, I think we got pretty much everything we can grab here. Oh, no, there's a couple more over here. They're worth it to get. You guys know how much these things heal you when they're fully cooked together. So, absolutely picking them up. Mighty Thistle, Hardy Durian. Okay, last tree. And hello, Farosh! Nice to see you. Coming out of down there by the waterfall. Are you going into the waterfall? You just going for a swim? Alright, I'll leave Farosh to do his thing. He's just hanging out. Hello, Keese! I don't wanna- don't use my Daruk's protection. Thank you. I don't need you to do that. Alright, Revali, you're coming out, buddy. We need your help. I hope this storm, like, subsides soon, because I do not feel like traversing to this shrine while the storm's going on. Also, we are definitely not doing the shrine behind the stable in this episode. Absolutely not. We got too much, it's taking us too long to, like, get over to this one. I was gonna call Horse, but I don't want to subject him to the storm. Look at Farosh. Coming out of the water. Farosh is so pretty. All these dragons are so pretty. Just appreciate them flying around. Alright, shrine nearby. I don't actually think the shrine that's beeping is the one that we're going for. That looks Koroki. Hello. Just gonna get rid of you guys real quick. If you're- Whoa! Where'd your friend come from? Kill him, Link. There you go. Yeah, this looks very Koroki, but we're not gonna worry about it right now. We're gonna do Koroks at a later date. Don't you worry. It's gonna happen. Cryonis, get across here. We got this dude to deal with. Or completely not deal with. Wait, why am I in the water? Link, he has an electric special rod thing. Don't get in the water. Terrible idea. Okay, so it's right over there. We got one gale left. And there's Farosh again! Hello! Maybe we don't even need to- use the gale, because Farosh is right here to help us out. Well, thank you, my friend. Could you send me a little higher? You're not gonna send me any higher. Alright, well, that's fine. You go do your thing. Stop trying to hit me with lightning balls. And I'll just be on my way. Oh god, there's another one of those dudes. Oh, there's the dragon music playing. I like how Farosh was just hanging out with us for a while there. Like, we're not doing anything. We're not attacking it, we're not fighting any enemies, we're not doing anything like that. Farosh just wanted to chill. And I'm fine with that. Totally fine with that. Revali, it's your time to shine. Oh, I probably should have been a little bit closer, but that's alright. Oh no, the rain's back! Okay, come on, Link. You got your climber's gear on. You can do it. We'll do five. One, two, three, four, five, jump. One, two, three, four, five, jump. Okay. We good. We're good. We're fine. We got it. We got it. We're fine. There's an Octorok in the water, and that is a waterfall. So, let's maybe make sure that we don't fall down there. I guess, in hindsight... Oh no. I remember the part I just said about not falling in the water and going down the waterfall. Put on your Zora gear, buddy. Okay, you fell down. It's fine. It's cool. Because we're in our Zora gear. We can just swim right back up. That's what I was trying to say before. In hindsight, it doesn't matter if we fall down because we have the Zora gear. But still. Alright. Cool. We made it up the mountain. Put on the... Okay, did I just take that off? No. Okay, put on the climber's gear. Hop! One, two, three, four, five, hup! Alright, so what is this thing? Supposedly it's a shrine. And I hear Cass. Oh, my boy! What do you got to tell me, buddy? Surely you know about this, right? You know all about whatever's going on up here? Very impressive. Not many could make it up here in such rain. I'd expect no less from a well-worn traveler like yourself. Me? I stay nice and dry. My feathers repel the rain rather well. And my instrument was designed to withstand extreme moisture. When your livelihood revolves around ancient songs, you've got to be prepared for a few raindrops. I know a song about this place. Would you like to hear the ancient verse passed down in this region? Let's hear it. Excellent. Without further ado... When a lost hero calls down lightning from the sky, the monk responds from a giant mound on high. Well, I'm the lost hero. There's a puzzle in this somewhere, but as far as I can tell, it could apply to a great many things. Anyway, may the light shine ever on your path. Thank you again, Cass. I appreciate you. A Song of Storms is what this one is called. Please don't run into me! Jesus, that freaking... ox or bull or whatever that was. So... you have two options here. We can either go up to the top... Welcome back, Farosh. We can either go up to the top of this thing, and get hit by lightning ourselves, or do this. Wait, was that not right? Do I have to be standing down here so it actually hits the top? Wait, do it again, Link. Huh? I thought I could use Urbosa's Fury. I guess I'm not close enough? Or not, hold on. Do it again. Did that hit it? Okay, never mind. We're getting hit by lightning today, folks, because it didn't want to work with Urbosa's Fury. I could have sworn that you can use Urbosa's Fury for this, but I suppose not. Alright, get up there, Link. We need to do a little bit of preparation here. We're gonna put on... Or not gonna have a shield on. Remove that. We're not gonna have a bow on. We're just gonna have on the Master Sword. We're gonna put on our best defensive gear, which I imagine is probably like this stuff too, right? Because it's 14, or... Well, no, I mean, that's our attack power. I don't know, 24? That's probably fine. We're also gonna go ahead and eat. We don't have a lot of, like, cooked stuff, so we'll just do... We'll just eat, like, apples to fully heal you. Alright. And then we're just gonna let it happen. Oh my god, there's Feroche again, going up into the clouds. Just hanging out with us this episode. Alright, I just gotta wait and literally just wait. I just gotta wait to get struck by lightning right now. Oh, it's happening immediately. Alright, Link. Maybe we bring up Daruk. That sounds like a good idea. It worked! Now, technically, I guess you don't have to stand there. You could just put a weapon on there and let that get hit by lightning. But that way's funnier. Alright, is this gonna be a blessing? Because it was technically part of a shrine quest. It is! Two blessings in a row! Hey, I'm fine with that. The Kukanata's blessing. We have... Rubber tights! These invaluable tights are resistant to electricity. They're made with something called rubber, an ancient technology that no longer exists in this modern age. They have shock resistance. So we now have the rubber tights and the rubber helm, and... This is what Link looks like wearing them. This is peak male performance. Okay, I'm not entirely certain where we get the middle part of this outfit, but hey, I'll take it. It makes sense that we get the rubber thing in the area full of lightning, right? That makes some pretty logical sense to me. Spirit orb required. Get out of here, Link. And I think with that, we are pretty much done for this episode. It's conveniently not raining now. That's nice. We've cleared out our pins, and well, I say that, we've cleared out our big glowy pins. You may have noticed I've actually put down a few stars on the map in a couple of places, I think like three, four places. I thought we might have gotten onto some other stuff in this episode, so that's what that was, but yeah, no, that was not happening. This took a little bit longer than I anticipated. That's gonna be what we take on next episode. Those are all shrine quests that I've gone ahead and pinned, because... Hey, we gotta do them eventually. We've got quite a few left, so figured it made sense to drop pins on them. All right, why can I not see this stable? Is it? Oh, it's like right across this bridge. This bridge is pretty. I'm about to fly over the whole thing, but look at it. That's real pretty. Oh, and there, sure enough, the shrine detector is going off. I'm pretty certain I know where it is. I'm honestly surprised that I missed this one when we were here last. But hey. It's fine. Also, I'm gonna let Daruk take a hit here. I'm gonna... There we go. Because I want him to be restored by next episode. So I think I'm gonna climb a tree. And then jump down and have Daruk protect me. Sounds like a plan. That was not high enough. Whatever, I'll do that between episodes and get us all prepped for next time. Where we'll be finding whatever the heck is hidden around here. The shrine thing, it's going off. That detector do be beeping. So, I found it. Alright, cool. We'll do that in the next one. If you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like. And of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.